Harper Audio presents Starting an eBay Business for Dummies, 3rd edition, written by Marsha Collier and read by Brett Barry. Copyright 2007 by Wiley Publishing, Inc. Production and abridgment copyright 2008 by HarperCollins Publishers. You're here. You've made it. Welcome to the 3rd edition of the best-selling audiobook on eBay Business, Starting an eBay Business for Dummies. This is what you need to make the leap from casual seller or buyer to online mogul. You've probably been on eBay for a while and have seen that there really is a huge opportunity to make a part or full-time living online. This recording will serve as your manual to get organized and get your eBay business launched. I've made a successful living while working out of my home for what seems like a lifetime. Those corporate newspaper years fade further into the background as time passes, and I share my personal experiences to show that you too can run a successful home business. I started my own marketing and advertising business so that I could be at home and near my daughter. She's a big-time executive now. Don't start counting the years, it's not polite. And I devote my time to selling on eBay. I'm a power seller, running my website, and writing and teaching for eBay University. Through perseverance and dedication, my small homegrown business financed my home and my daughter's upbringing, private school, and college education. I know that the only limits to my eBay business are time. With the information here and some hard work, you too can expand to be an online success. One thing that I can't guarantee is how much money you can earn. I've discovered, perhaps the hard way, that it takes a good deal of discipline to run a home business. Don't look for shortcuts. The time you spend and the amount of devotion you give your business will measure your success. Because you're listening to this, I assume you're getting serious about selling on eBay and want to find out the fine points of just how to do that. Or perhaps you want to know how much is involved in an eBay business so that you can make the decision whether to give it a go. If I have you figured out and you've decided that it's time to get serious, here are some other foolish assumptions I've made about you. You have a computer and an internet connection. You've bought and sold on eBay and are familiar with how it works. You have an existing small business, or you'd like to start one. You like the idea of not having to work set hours. You feel that working from home in jeans and a t-shirt is a great idea. I must stop here and say that it would really help, especially if your total transactions on eBay are less than 100, if you read my beginning book, eBay for Dummies, 5th edition. That book gives you all the basics you need to get started selling successfully. If you can say yes to my foolish assumptions, you're off and running. So you've decided to step up to the plate and start that eBay business. You should first decide how much time you have to devote. I suggest that you don't quit your day job yet. Instead, start expanding your sales in baby steps. You can sell part-time and still be a business and have a nice chunk of extra income. A large portion of sellers, even eBay power sellers, those who gross more than $1,000 a month in sales, work on eBay only part-time. eBay sellers come from all walks of life. A good number of stay-at-home moms are selling on eBay. And so many retirees are finding eBay a great place to supplement their income that I wouldn't be surprised if the AARP creates a special eBay arm. If you're pulled out of your normal work routine and faced with a new lifestyle, you can easily make the transition to selling on eBay. Before launching any business, including an eBay business, you need to set your priorities. And to be successful at that business, you must apply some clear level of discipline. I won't bore you with the now legendary story of how Pierre Omidyar started eBay to help fulfill his girlfriend's Pez dispenser habit, blah, blah, blah. I will tell you that he started auctionweb.com, the original eBay website, with a laptop, a regular internet service provider, ISP, and an old school desk. He and his buddy, Jeff Skoll, a Stanford MBA, ran AuctionWeb 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, all by themselves. When I began using the service, I had a lot of questions, and I always got prompt, friendly answers to my emails. When the site started attracting more traffic, Pierre's ISP began to complain about all the traffic and raised his monthly fees. To cover the higher costs, Pierre and Jeff began charging 25 cents to list an auction. Pierre was so busy running the site that the envelopes full of checks began to pile up. He didn't even have time to open the mail. When Pierre incorporated eBay AuctionWeb in 1997 with his partner Jeff, they were each drawing a salary of $25,000. Their first office consisted of one room, and they had one part-time employee to handle the payments. They started small and grew. Now, eBay is a respected worldwide corporation, employing thousands of people and trading on the New York Stock Exchange. A part-time eBay business can be very profitable. One thing that I stress is that the more time and energy you spend on your eBay business, the more money you can make. That said, let's examine the lowest possible level of time that you should devote to your business. Maybe you enjoy finding miscellaneous items to sell on eBay. You can find these items randomly in your day-to-day life. So let's suppose that you could spend at least a few hours, maybe 2 to 3, a day on eBay. Now you must include the time it takes to write up your auctions. If you're selling only one type of item, allow about 10 minutes to write your auction and photograph the item, or scan it, and upload it to eBay or a photo hosting site. How much time is required to perform these tasks varies from person to person and will improve according to your level of expertise. Regardless, every task in your eBay auction business takes time, and you must budget for that time. Crunched for time? The following are some features you're sure to find handy. HTML templates. Most experienced eBay sellers use preset templates to speed up the task of listing auctions, and this should be your goal. The Turbo Lister program. When you want to list a bunch of auctions at once, I recommend using the eBay Turbo Lister program. I estimate that Turbo Lister enables you to put together and upload 10 auctions in just 15 minutes. The Selling Manager and Selling Manager Pro programs. These eBay subscription programs can help you speed up the nuts and bolts of an ongoing eBay business when you're selling many items a week. Relisting or Sell Similar feature. When you sell the same item time after time, you can use Turbo Lister. It archives your listings so you can repeat them, or the handy eBay Relisting or Sell Similar feature. When your auction ends on eBay, links pop up, offering to relist your listing or to sell similar. If you want to run a different auction with a similar HTML format to the one that just ended, simply select the Sell Similar option and cut and paste the new title and description into the Sell Your Item page of your new listing. Use the relist feature only when an item hasn't sold the first time, so it will qualify for a listing fee credit when it sells. Use Sell Similar to relist the same item after it fails to sell a second time. You can take great photos and write brilliant descriptions, but cashmere sweaters won't sell for as much in the heat of summer as they do in winter. Doing your research can take up a good deal of time when you're selling a varied group of items. Only you can decide how much time you can afford to spend researching going rates for items on eBay. You also have to consider how much time it takes to shop for your merchandise. You may have to travel to dealers, go to auctions, or spend time online discovering new ways to find your auction merchandise. Many sellers set aside a full day each week for this undertaking. Your merchandise is what makes you money, so don't skimp on the time you spend identifying products. Here's a list of various activities that you must perform when doing business on eBay. Photograph the item. Upload the images to eBay Picture Services when you list, or before listing, to your ISP or third-party hosting service. Pack and weigh the item to determine the shipping cost. Choose an auction title with popular keywords. Write a concise and creative description. List the item for sale on eBay. Answer bidding questions. Send an end-of-listing email, can be automated through PayPal. Carry out bookkeeping and banking. Address the label and affix postage. Ship the item safely and securely. Time yourself to see how long it takes to accomplish each of these tasks. The time varies when you list multiple items, so think of the figures that you come up with as your baseline, a minimum amount of time that you must set aside. This information can help you decide how many hours per week or month you need to devote to running your part-time eBay business. The best way to go full-time on eBay is to first run your business part-time for a few months to iron out the wrinkles. Running a full-time business on eBay is the perfect option for working parents who prefer staying at home with their children, retirees looking for a way to supplement their income, or those who just rather do something else than work for their boss. What should I sell? That is the million-dollar question. In your quest for merchandise, you're bound to hear about soft goods and hard goods. Soft, or non-durable, goods are generally textile products, such as clothing, fabrics, and bedding. Hard goods are computer equipment, housewares, and anything else that's basically non-disposable. Following are just a few points to consider when you're deciding what to sell. Shipping costs. Some differences exist between shipping hard and soft goods. Soft goods can fold up and be packed in standard box sizes, available from the USPS, U.S. Postal Service, or better yet, in bubble or Tyvek envelopes for much lower shipping costs. Most hard goods come in their own boxes, which may or may not be individually shippable. You'll also need to use styrofoam peanuts or bubble cushioning, or double package the item in an oddly sized box. Other shipping considerations. Do you want to handle large boxes and deal with the hassles of shipping them? Do you enjoy dealing with your products? I would have been out of the eBay game years ago if I was forced to sell auto parts. Enjoying what you sell makes you an expert and a top drawer seller. Possible storage problems. Do you have the room to store enough merchandise to keep you going? Soft goods can take up considerably less space than hard goods. You don't always have to buy your items in bulk to make money on eBay. The first things you sell might be items you find in your garage or attic. If you have a collection of your own, eBay is a great way to find rare items. Because your collection is something dear to your heart and you've studied it on and off for years, you could probably call yourself an expert. Bingo! You're an expert at something! I recommend that you hone your skills to find things in your area of expertise at discount prices. You're liking this more and more, aren't you? And then sell them on eBay for a profit. Start small and start with something you know. Sometimes just the idea of a part-time business can throw you into a tizzy. After all, don't you have enough to do? School, work, soccer, kids glued to the TV. You might sometimes feel as if you've no time for family time. However, the importance of family time is what brought me to eBay in the first place. I was working long hours in my own business, and at the end of the day, when my daughter Susan wanted to go shopping, perhaps for some Hello Kitty toy or a Barbie doll, I was just too tired. Can you relate? I'd heard about AuctionWeb, eBay's original site name, from a friend, and had bought some things online for my own collections. Okay, you got me. I collected Star Trek stuff. Call me Geek with a capital G. I'd also browsed around the site and found some popular toys selling for reasonable prices. So one evening, I introduced Susan to AuctionWeb, and life has never been the same. We'd go to toy stores together right when they opened on Saturday morning, so we'd get first dibs on shipments of the hottest, newest toys. She'd go to the dolls, and I'd go to the action figures. We'd buy several, go home, and post them for sale on eBay. We made money, yes, but the best part was our toy runs. They will always remain a special memory. Susan has since graduated from college. She majored in business and marketing, must have been inspired by our eBay enterprise, but she still calls home when she finds a hot CD or closeouts of a top-selling item. We still purchase and list items together. The family that eBays together always does. My short trip down memory lane has a point. A family business can succeed, and everyone can enjoy it. I was in charge of the financing and the packing, while Susan looked up zip codes on the internet and put pins in a 4-foot by 5-foot map showing every city that we bought or sold from. She learned some excellent lessons in marketing, advertising, and geography, all in one swoop. Having children in your home brings you closer to the latest trends than you could ever imagine. I remember sitting at a Starbucks a couple of years ago, watching some dads and their sons poring over notebooks full of Pokemon cards. Actually, the kids were off playing somewhere, and the dads were coveting the cards. And what about Star Wars? Star Trek? G.I. Joe? Can you say action figures? If guys have them, they're not dolls. They're action figures. If you have access to the latest and greatest toys, buy them up and sell them to those who can't find them in their neck of the woods. If your home is like mine, books pile up by the tens.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.